Tell me a joke Harmony, okay? That beautiful ball of cheese is my personal property. Ooh la la. The moon has mine. The moon is mine. The moon is mine.
Thank you. not gonna give her another shot because she'll steal the show. The moon.
I'm still fascinated by the music of the 30s, 40s and 50s, you know, I think it's...
It's so refreshing, much... isn't it, now? Because
it's beautiful.
It's been such
music,
a long,
you know,
time,
yeah,
before...
It's lovely not to hear a backbeat playing. That's like a concrete block hitting you over the head, you know, I just can't really listen to that kind of music. And so I think, you know, I think there's a place for it still, you know. There's a lot of music that people have never heard made in that time, which I think people really love, you know. Mm. Hopefully we're helping people to enjoy that, you know.
Have you always been drawn to that as well, Eddie?
Well, not always. I kind of went through phases of lots of different kind of music, but before Fairground Attraction, I got into Piaf and the 30s music and Ella Fitzgerald and stuff like that. I kind of felt, no, why can't somebody write songs like that, you know, that I can sing and that can test you? I mean, most of the stuff I was doing was like, ooh, baby, ooh, boom, boom, ooh, baby, ooh, and that's all you said. And I thought, this is pathetic. What am I doing in this business? I'd rather be scrubbing floors. Or...
Tonight, time is only as a bubble out on the sea when the night. Yeah, the guitar and I play is it's a Mexican instrument, which they play in mariachi bands, which are like the street bands in Mexico. And I just fell in love with the sound, really. It's a very sad, kind of deep, rich sound, which seems to go very well with the kind of the lyrical and kind of the sentiments of the songs.
It strikes me that a lot of your songs are quite reflective and very personal and very melodic. How do you cope with having somebody else singing them, or do you ever sing them yourself?
No, I never sing. Well, I do sing them myself when I write them, obviously, but I try to avoid letting my voice being heard because it's just so horrible. But it's weird, actually. Kind of, I think it gives you a sort of funny relationship, you know, between me and Eddie, because she's out there performing, you know, what something I've written, and vice versa. It's kind of weird. It's hard to explain it.
If I choose to sing Mark E. Nevin's songs, it's because those particular ones that I choose, I mean, because he writes hundreds, are because they affect me personally. And so when I sing it, it's my personal love song, not his, you know what I mean? He might have written it about his girlfriend, but I'm singing it about my boyfriend, you know what I mean?
Jazz in the basement bar, moon's on the rain. I've drunk too much, I've spent too much, I'm penniless again. Oh, sweetheart, where are you tonight? I remember when we used to walk by the Thames. The lights on the embankment like jewels on chains. I'll never forget what you said at the start. You said I'll put a string of lights round your heart. I've got your photograph, the one that you signed, tucked in my pocket, all tattered by a sign. Oh, sweetheart, who's with you tonight? Are you there at the roundabout, down in the park, where you'd sneak through the railings when it's locked after dark? Is she learning the song you taught me at the start, the one the bells and the banjos played on our hearts? The bars are all empty, everybody's gone home. Perhaps I'll walk down the embankment alone. Oh, sweetheart, I'm glad that we met, and that there's jazz in the basement bars and jewels on chains. 'Cause I've drunk too much and spent too much, but there's
thank you for that harmony. Sang this before together, haven't we? God bless you. A little bit of Scottish country dancing from the audience, especially them up there. If you can't go and dance, just do that.
Another 20.
Well, with Whispers, I was sort of interested in this story I was reading about the Madonna, you know, the Madonna of Our Lady appearing in Medjugorje in Yugoslavia. And I kind of liked the idea that she was whispering invisibly into these children's ears and telling them about how life is and what the things that, you know, that make sense for life, which is she's doing now. And I kind of thought it was like what mothers did and her being a mother. So it's kind of about the mother of life, the mother of earth.
When she whispers the stories I have heard, in captivation my eyes are wide with her word. So much respect in you, my heart is blowing up to burst. With one step forward she leads me by the hand. I think I'll make it with stars up in the sky. It's sure we're all the same and someday soon they say we all must die. Tell them all, wrap them up in fire with your love. Here I am, just the wind. The wind knows my name and it's calling me, calling me, calling me again. I think that you knew right from the start there was this restlessness in my heart. It's a feeling that I have tried to tame, but it's hard when the wind knows your name and it's calling me, calling me, calling me again. It's a cruel wind. Tired and bitter eyes, so dry your eyes, no more tears. Hold me once and I'll walk out of here. Who knows, one day we'll meet again. But don't wait for me, cause the wind knows my name and it's calling me, calling me, calling me again. Yes, it's calling me, calling me, calling me again. Sing this part. It's the part that Roger's playing.
Down, 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 down
a pile of pish, but don't win. I can cut it out, it's all right.
Children with candy floss and prizes of goldfish, young men kilt in decks and sharpshooter poses, the laughter of the lovers on the rickety stairs. The rumble of the diesel and the sounds of the fair. An old gypsy lady in soft Spanish whispers took my hands in hers and told me their secrets. Your heart is an ember. You must forget what you'll always remember. Superstitious nonsense, just a fairground attraction. I walk through the neons in search of distraction. Tears in my heart. She'd only confirm what I knew.
Miles along the highway, where the
having a family has just made my life so finished, and not finished, but round, instead of bits missing here and there, you know. It's lovely to have a family, and being on the road is easy because I've got a partner, my husband, who does all the work, really. I mean, he looks after Charlie, my baby, and his baby and my baby, and he takes full responsibility while I'm working, which is fabulous. I don't think there's many men that would do that.
Do that again. Yes! It's got to be.
Scottish accent as well. Brilliant!